Queensland is home to six of the world's seven species of marine turtles and supports some of the largest marine turtle nesting areas in the Indo-Pacific region. Because marine turtles are highly mobile, they can potentially interact with a variety of fishing apparatus used by Queensland's commercial fishers. Fortunately, the risk to turtles that was once posed by trawl fisheries has now largely been reduced by Turtle Excluder Devices, or TEDs, which allow these animals and other large species, such as sharks and rays, to escape the net upon capture. TEDs and other recognised bycatch reduction devices are mandatory in all otter trawl nets of vessels fishing in the Queensland East Coast trawl fishery. This measurement and inspection guide will help compliance officers, net manufacturers and fishers ensure the TEDs they see, make and use are compliant with the current regulations. A TED inspection should take no more than a few minutes. To measure a TED grid or frame, begin by gathering a row of mesh 1 to 2 metres above the TED section. An easy place to do this is where the TED section joins the main net. While holding the net, slide up the netting 1 to 2 metres and attach a whip line at this point. Have a crew member lift the TED approximately waist high off the deck and place the cod end directly under the TED. This will ensure that the angle of the grid is accurate. Measure the height and width of the grid to ensure it is at least 81 centimetres in both directions. These measurements should be taken at a midpoint on the grid both vertically and horizontally and to the outer edge of the grid frame. Place the non-magnetic side of the angle meter on the centre grid bar to check the angle of the device. The angle measurement must read 55 degrees or less. To work out the angle measurement without an angle meter, the mesh count method can also be used. To do this, follow along a row of meshes from the bottom of the grid to the midpoint directly below the top of the grid. The mesh count is the number of meshes between this point and the top of the grid. The table in the appendix of the TED guide will allow you to calculate the minimum number of meshes required to meet grid angle specifications. This table accounts for variations in grid height and mesh size. Measure the distance between the grid bars to ensure they do not exceed 12 centimetres. Any bent bars exceeding this measurement need to be straightened by the fisher. Regulations require that the grid be attached to the entire circumference of the net with rope or heavy twine, and the deflector bars run from top to bottom as it is positioned in the net. Next, measure the escape hole cut. For rectangular openings, this measurement must be a minimum of 61 centimetres, and for the larger triangular openings, it must be a minimum of 102 centimetres. The cut must not finish any more than 10 centimetres from the edge of the grid to ensure pockets at the sides of the grid do not form and hinder the escape of turtles. For example, on a grid that is 1 metre wide, the escape opening cut must measure a minimum of 80 centimetres. When inspecting double and single flap TEDs, begin by measuring the forward cut on each side. This should measure at least 51 centimetres for double flap TEDs, 66 centimetres for single flap rectangular TEDs, and 136 centimetres for single flap triangular TEDs. Next, measure the trailing edge of the flap panels. For both double and single flap TEDs, they must hang past the posterior edge of the grid no more than 61 centimetres. Now, check the attachment of the flaps. On the single flap TED, Ensure the flap is not sewn more than 15 centimetres below the posterior edge of the grid by measuring 15 centimetres down from the grid and following the row of meshes across to a point where the flap intersects. Next, measure the flap to ensure it does not overlap the escape hole opening by more than 13 centimetres at the point where the escape hole cut intersects the grid. The flap needs to have a minimum stretched width of 338 centimetres. To achieve this flap width, there must be a minimum of 67 meshes in a single flap, with a maximum allowable mesh size of 50 millimetres. On double flap TEDs, the outer edge of the panels may be attached to the TED section down the entire length. Next, measure the overlap. On the double flap TEDs, measure the amount of overlap to ensure it does not exceed 38 centimetres at the point where the flaps attach to the TED section. This measurement is taken as the flaps hang and is not a stretched measurement. Ensure flaps are only attached together along their leading edge and the mesh size is no greater than 50 millimetres. Lower the device to the deck and remove the whip line, as the following measurement should be taken with the device lying on the deck. Measure the leading edge cut. This cut should measure at least 142 centimetres on double flap TEDs and 181 centimetres on single flap TEDs when stretched. For a bottom shooter TED, measure the outer circumference of the device to determine the amount of flotation required. Top shooter TEDs do not require the use of floats. The flotation for bottom shooter TEDs must comply with either dimension or buoyancy requirements. If using hard plastic floats, a grid of any size requires as a minimum either one hard plastic float 25 centimetres in diameter, two floats 20 centimetres in diameter, or three floats 15 centimetres in diameter. Floats may be attached inside or outside of the TED, but if inside, must be behind the grid. Floats are not to be attached to the flaps. Styrofoam floats are not to be used. If the circumference of the grid is less than or equal to 305 centimetres, then it must have at least one EVA or PVC float, measuring a minimum of 17 centimetres in diameter and 22 centimetres in length. If two EVA or PVC floats are attached, they must measure a minimum of 15 centimetres in diameter and 18 centimetres in length. If the circumference of the grid is greater than 305 centimetres, it must have at least two of the 17 by 22 centimetre floats or four of the 15 by 18 centimetre floats attached. Plastic grids do not require additional flotation if the construction material has a density less than or equal to seawater, which is 1.025 grams per cubic centimetre. This value must be permanently marked on the grid. When floats are required to meet buoyancy requirements, they may be used in any combination of size and buoyancy, as long as the combined buoyancy of the floats equals or exceeds the weight of the grid. Floats must be permanently marked with the buoyancy, expressed in grams or kilograms, and the grid must be permanently marked with the weight in air, expressed in grams or kilograms. All of the measurement and inspection procedures outlined in this guide are important to ensuring that TEDs are compliant with current regulations, allowing turtles to escape safely while retaining high catch rates. Fisheries Queensland is continuing to work with fishers to ensure the refinement and ongoing improvement of their TEDs and other bycatch reduction devices. For further information, visit www.fisheries.qld.gov.au or call 13 25 23.